Well, so hello. We decided to take the features from the neural networks that we've seen before and use them for search-based classification. For this, we have divided our task in few steps. First, we have a feature extraction, sort of a pre-processing where we generate the features with the models. It's done in Python, and there we generate comma-separated values files. And those files we then use for the indexing. So we have the features already pre-processed there. And then with the created index, we search it and then use the results from the searches to do the classification. And yeah, the feature extraction works in with some pre-trained neural networks. We combine those all together in the index. And basically they're all pre-trained on the ImageNet dataset. And just to reduce the data that we generate with there, we added an additional dense layer and a pooling layer so that we get the feature vectors down to 1024 values or less. Because, for example, the VGG 16 and 19 networks only produce 512 networks, and so we don't want to blow them up for no reason because it's not going to. And we also perform a numeric quantization, so basically, we transform the double values in our case mostly to integer values, but we try different data types and see. To find out how the effect that has on the performance. For the indexing, we create a Lucene index with the Lyra library. So basically, we make documents out of it that we then can search. We created indexes with bit sampling and metric spaces hashing just to see the difference. And basically, since we use eight neural networks, we generate eight index entries per image that we have. So, and those were for the searching, we have then eight different searches for each image. So, and those researchers are then combined and used for the classification. So basically, we have a nearest neighbor approach for that. And at the last stage, doing our experiments, we noticed through some output that we had that some models perform better at other things than the other models, so we added some weights to our classification as well to improve the results a bit. And for the task, we submitted four runs. The first one was with the features with the 1024, that's for all, so the length is all the same. And we had three runs with integer features, and the last one we used the standard features without any numeric quantization. And you see we have first two runs have the different hashing methods for creating an index and the searching. And in the run three, we tried with both features. So basically, we created two indexes and then searched in both of them, basically doubling our search results and then combining those for the classification. And the last, we just used the double features without any numeric quantization to just have a reference what the numeric quantization does to it. So for the results, we see the accuracy values are fairly high, but the other, the F1 score and the MCC get fairly low because there's still a lot of confusion, as we see on the next slide then. So here are the main problem areas are as for others, the out-of-patient class and instruments, since we are looking for similar images, basically, it doesn't help if you only have four images in our index, so we can't really find much there. And for instruments, there are also like 30 images or something, so it also is a bit low. And we also have the same problem as the speakers before with esophagitis getting classified as New Zealand or the other way around. And there's also a lot of confusion between the diet lifted bolus and the diet resection margins, since the images are very similar. And maybe it would help if you had some networks that are actually trained on the medical domain that maybe look more out for those color differences there rather than rather general trained models on the ImageNet networks. So, and also to be used in an actual medical setting in hospitals, we would need to rework the system so that the feature extraction is actually included in the classification so that it can be done as one step. Because at the moment, we create for training and for the testing data the CSV files that we then use. So that step needs to be eliminated and incorporated to the classification task so that you can actually do it while you're doing the examination. That's also why we didn't include any performance metrics or memory metrics, because it's kind of pointless to analyze that now when you need the system to work differently anyway. But we could see that it still works fairly well, even though we don't use the full potential of the neural networks probably.